Hello there and welcome back to Imola, home circuit of the Scuderia Ferrari. We expect to see a lot of local supporters wearing red today, and they've all turned out for what we're expecting will be a sensational event here at the Emilia-Romagna Grand Prix. 3.1 miles of track at Imola featuring 19 turns, 9 to the right and 10 to the left. Remember that Imola differs from most other Formula One tracks as it's taken anti-clockwise. Let's hope nobody forgets that today. The exit from turn 18 will probably be the setup for many of today's overtakes, leading as it does into the longest straight on the circuit, and it's only DRS zone. Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. A fantastic effort from Charles Leclerc yesterday, and it's put him on pole. And a very happy Carlos Sainz will start second. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Hamilton, Ocon, Daniel Ricciardo, and Magnussen, Perez, Albon, Vettel, and Mick Schumacher, Bottas, Joe, Yuki Tsunoda, and Norris. They'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty. Gasly, Latifi, Lance Stroll, and Max Verstappen, Russell, and Oldtimer. It's almost time for the lights to go out, so let's head down to the track where preparations are underway. It's race day yet again, and joining me for a chat is Anthony Davidson. Ant, our racers are certainly in for a rough day today. What will you be watching out for as they head into turn one?
Well, the start of the race is always one of the most nerve-wracking parts. You have to hope that everyone is able to get off to a clean start, and this is possibly the trickiest part of the entire race. So many drivers in such a small space, and finding your braking point into turn one as well. It's a testament to the driver's skill that there aren't more incidents.
So everything looks good on the power unit cycles, so let's concentrate on bringing tyres and brakes up to temperature. terrible. Stay focused.
It's a performance that our Emilia-Romagna Grand Prix winners can be justifiably proud of. And I'm sure there'll be celebrations tonight. Talk to me, Ants. What was it that set them apart from the competition today?
Well, I honestly feel it was down to the driver and car today. I mean, we can talk driver skill all day, but if you don't have a solid team to back that, you're never going to get anywhere. When you hit that sweet spot of having both an excellent driver and an incredible car, that's when you see results like those we witnessed today.
Looking at the podium, you can see that red suit familiar to fans across the globe. A world-class win for a world-class team. Ferrari, do it again. Let's have a look then at the driver's standings. Charles Leclerc's points today take him to the top of the championship standings. Some amazing talent out on the track today, but Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
But there's no question in my mind, it has to go to George Russell. What a performance. He's got every right to be proud of what he accomplished out there today.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. No change in the top spot then, but with today's points, their hold on that lead is getting weaker. Meanwhile, good work from Aston Martin this weekend, who pushed themselves further up the order. Well, what an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.